It's Friday, March 13. Welcome to today's edition of Jamaica Magazine. We have lots in store for you today. I'm Adrian Atkinson and I'll be sharing the pages with you. We close off Math Week with a look at a math expo by the Ministry of Education and shed some light on an initiative to create more financially literate kids. Plus, the GIS recently selected its winners for the 2014 GIS Heritage Essay and Poster Competitions. We meet those who made it to the top five. So stick around, all this unfolds right after this timely message and the news.
They were heading home, playing in the streets just like they always did. When...
My name is Sheldon Bell. I barely survived. My friend, she didn't. I'm now much more careful on the road. You should be too.
330 Jamaicans died in road crashes in 2014. 99 of the deceased were pedestrians. Road users, obey road rules. Walk, drive, and ride with care. Remember, road safety begins with you.
Good day, I'm Stacey Ann Smith, and this is your GIS News for Friday, March 13. Finance Minister Dr. Peter Phillips opened the budget debate Thursday afternoon and announced fiscal measures designed to not only generate revenue, but also improve tax compliance and protect Jamaica's economic reform gains. Simone Wolf has the details.
The finance minister told Parliament that while there was a budget gap of $22 billion for fiscal year 2015-2016, government would only seek $10.4 billion of that amount from taxes.
Tax compliance efforts are expected to provide $12.3 billion.
To help secure the remaining $10.4 billion, $488 million will be earned from an increase to the special consumption tax on every stick of cigarette. GCT at the standard rate will be reimposed on residential electricity usage above 350 kilowatt hours, yielding $807 million. The 0.5% environmental levy on imported goods will now also apply to domestic sales, with some exceptions, to earn $962 million. And $500 million will come from rationalizing several outdated trade and business license fees. Government also expects to earn $6.4 billion from an increase to the specific SCT rates on petrol, which will be used to insure against the prospect of further sharp increases to international oil prices and the potential negative consequences for Jamaica's economy.
Accordingly, Mr. Speaker, the government has taken the decision to purchase a hedge in the market. We propose to hedge 50% of our oil consumption. What I'm saying here does not affect the electricity component.
$1.8 billion, meanwhile, is to be earned by replacing the 1% petroleum cess paid by Petrojam to the Petroleum Corporation of Jamaica with a specific SCT of $2 per liter. Dr. Phillips stressed that this would have no impact on Petrojam's reference billing prices for petroleum products. Minimal revenue will come from expanding the policy to eliminate zero rating under the GCT Act to all but a few government entities and from the introduction of a 3% withholding tax on some specified services. Other fiscal measures will offer no revenue gains but are designed to stimulate some industries and offset the social impact of the economic reform initiative. These include a further increase to the income tax threshold to $592,800 per annum effective January 1, 2016, allowing workers to take home more of their pay. The asset tax rate for life insurance companies, which was increased to 1% last year, has been cut to 0.25% in line with other financial institutions, while the gross premium tax and the net investment income tax for the insurance industry will be abolished and a corporate tax of 25% introduced. Simone Wolf reporting for GIS News.
And the private sector organization of Jamaica, PSOJ, has given the finance minister high marks for the growth-inducing strategy he unveiled as he opened the budget debate Thursday. PSOJ Chief Executive Officer Dennis Chung says the government remains on the right track. Mr. Chung has also lauded the administration for strategies such as the newly announced hedge fund program, which will act as insurance, protecting the country from potential shock from any spike in oil prices.
We are in full support of the hedging.
In full support of that?
PSOJ. Right, the president of PSOJ has come out and said he's in full support of that. And we think that this is a good place at which to try and hold a reasonable price. So, you know, we'll wait on the details of that, but we're in support of the principle.
Mr. Chung made the comments during a JIS TV special panel discussion on the finance minister's budget presentation. Meanwhile, during Dr. Phillips's budget presentation, it was also revealed that the Development Bank of Jamaica, DBJ, had exceeded its targeted $3 billion loan commitment to micro, small and medium-sized enterprises, MSMEs, for the current fiscal year.
They exceeded it by $300 million and, in fact, have approved in excess of 8,800 loans.
For the 2015-2016 fiscal year, DBJ has committed to lend $4 billion to MSMEs. Under its loan guarantee program, DBJ will also increase the maximum value of its guarantee from $10 million to $15 million to cover up to 50% of loans to small and medium enterprises. Guarantees will be provided for up to 80% on small business loans below $6.2 million to cover a maximum of $5 million. And Dr. Phillips revealed that 8 local and international fund managers have responded to the DBJ's call to submit proposals for venture capital funding.
The DBJ and some investors are now doing due diligence on 6 of the fund managers, and it is expected that in the course of the 15-16 fiscal year, 1 or 2 fund managers will be actively operating.
In other news, the recently announced Memorandum of Understanding MOU to invest $5 billion in Jamaica's logistics hub initiative is expected to be signed next week with a foreign investor.
It's a consortium of Austrian and American persons and investors and developers. The MOU will be signed next week. We are in the throes of finalizing the arrangements. The investors will be here shortly, and we'll then finalize everything, but I'm confident that we'll be able to sign the MOU next week.
The industry minister says the MOU will facilitate a series of infrastructure projects and will transform the business landscape for logistics and position the country for increased investments. It will bring total investments in the logistics hub initiative to $6.5 billion, more than half the $10 billion target. Minister Hilton was speaking at the 2015 Jamaica Investment Forum in Montego Bay. JAMPRO's chairman, Milton Samuda, says the forum facilitated over 160 business meetings, adding that investors have expressed strong interest in a number of sectors, including business process outsourcing and tourism.
There are 2 hotel projects which I feel, even at this early stage, fairly certain will happen over the next 2 to 3 years. And people need to understand that it does take that time for it to unfold.
And finally, the National Environment and Planning Agency, NEPA, continues to monitor air quality in the corporate area and sections of St. Catherine affected by smoke from a fire at the Riverton City landfill. Smoke blanketed sections of Spanish Town Road and 3 miles in the vicinity of the landfill Friday, even as crews from the Jamaica Fire Brigade and other agencies battled the blaze. The Office of Disaster Preparedness and Emergency Management, ODPEM, issued a caution to motorists to avoid the area if possible. And schools in the corporate area and St. Catherine were also ordered closed on Friday, while the Health Ministry cautioned persons in the area with respiratory illnesses to use a damp rag to reduce the impact of the smoke. In the meantime, officials are still trying to source specialized equipment to help fight the blaze.
We are really seeking owners of D9 and D10 equipment to contact us at numbers 906-967-425 or 754-9077-28. I'm going to say that again because we have been making calls all this time for persons with these equipment to come forward, but it has now become necessary for us to make this a public call.
On Thursday, the state minister chaired a meeting of the interagency task force that's managing the situation. The ODPEM is the agency leading the efforts to get the situation under control. And that's it for JIS News today. I'm Stacey Ann Smith. Thank you for watching.
Parents, make sure the children get immunized. Hear this! Immunization, it is a must. This is not a joke thing, this you can trust. It is required by law for entry to nursery, to daycare and to schools. Listen up, it is necessary to prevent diseases such as the measles, the poliomyelitis, the lockjaw and the whooping cough. Immunize your kids, keep them healthy, keep them strong. Prevent deadly diseases such as mumps, rubella and diphtheria. Immunize your child today. Immunization, a key to good health.
A message from the Ministry of Health and PAHO.
Math Counts has been the theme for National Math Week, which ends today. Observation of the week began in 2013 as part of the ministry's interventions to change students' and teachers' attitudes towards mathematics. Take a look now at how the annual Mathematics Expo has been effective in doing just that.
Not liking maths, then you can just say goodbye to any of these professions. Claims adjuster, chemist, engineer, sociologist, even nurse. Welcome to another week of School Zone. I'm Tamara McHale, and today we give you highlights of the Ministry of Education Maths Expo, held under the theme Math Revolution Equal Economic Solution. There was an even more serious goal to the day's activities.
We want you to see the different career opportunities and to set your goals to qualify yourselves in mathematics so that you can be gainfully employed in Jamaica and elsewhere in the globe.
And that's exactly what happened, as captivated students listened to presenters sharing the importance of mathematics in various professions.
It doesn't matter where in the world you are, what subjects you like, or what decision you have to make, math is the first thing that you have to consider.
There was even one presenter from as far as Singapore, the country which ranks the best in mathematics and science globally, according to results from the Trends in International Mathematics and Science Study.
Mathematics in Singapore is different. There's a new methodology in mathematics. Okay, we call it the CPA concept, concrete, pictorial, and abstract. Along with it, we have methodologies like bar modeling. It's used widely now. We have spread the word across the world.
In the CPA method, you move from actual objects around you, concrete, then you create pictures, pictorial, and the final stage is using math symbols to connect it all, abstract. This helps students picture numbers and sizes in their minds so they can work out mathematical equations. With the help of 32 exhibitors, 6,000 students from 200 schools across the island, maybe even yours, got to working it out.
10 gram pieces, and the aim of the 10, of there are 7 pieces cut from a square, and they are supposed to design, to create those designs that you see out there by combining the shapes.
Vertical movement and the horizontal movement just by looking, counting on this. We went to the, what's this, to the right, so it's positive, and went up, so that is also positive. So it's 6 over 6, which is 1. So the gradient is positive 1.
Yes. Y equals x plus 1.
I'm very elated. I'm thinking that the Ministry of Education is now heading in the right direction.
This Math Expo, I must say, it was rather fun and interesting.
That the CXC exam is coming up, it's very beneficial because we can learn a lot from this.
It's always an easier way to math, there's an easier way to look at it, and you can relate the strategies to things in daily life. For example, the lady was talking about algebra, and she was saying that you could look on algebra as dressing up. So you would put on one garment at a time. And when you realize it is really simple, you're just like everyday life.
It's budget season, and yesterday you would have heard the Minister of Finance outlining how government intends to finance the budget for the upcoming fiscal year. But matters of money and budgeting don't affect adults only. Students, what if you had $10 and wanted a biscuit that costs $20? Would you give what you had and then owe the balance, borrow the balance from a friend, or would you wait until you had saved some more cash? Well, as you think about that, the Ministry of Education has partnered with Money Basics Limited to ensure more of our students become financially literate. Take a look.
The project, Taking Charge of the Financial Future, is timely as the Ministry of Education is currently assessing literacy and numeracy levels among children in the grade 4 age cohort. The Financial Literacy Program complements the Junior Achievement Program that provides primary level students with exposure to business practice. And the Ministry hopes that the infusion of financial information into the school curriculum will redound to the personal benefit of students and teachers alike. You can infuse the basics of money literacy, financial literacy, money management into every single subject.
Our national agenda, entire goals as we move forward to develop Jamaica is all intertwined in the objectives of this initiative. Project Taking Charge of the Financial Future of Youths in Jamaica is at the cost of developing more fiscally responsible young individuals, not just for today, but also for tomorrow. And it is an investment that we know will be worth it.
Hey, Howard Wagwan.
What happened, Tamika, when you come from country?
Well, last week, my day, you know?
Where you coming from, champs?
Definitely.
Boy, I tell you, I smell the picture already.
He got jokes, and my school's the winnings every year.
We will see. But serious thing though, you know, 4 year students to transmit a big peace and friendly rivalry in a champs.
The youth, them start build, start respect each other, and to tell you the truth, boys and girls champs has truly come a far way.
Yeah, but you see, the disrespect in the skill, them have to go cut out. You see, the whole heap of back up flinging and fighting. And what that for, Tamika?
We need to understand that although we support different schools, it's still one Jamaica.
So youth and youth, the champs 2012, let's have a peaceful one. Don't bother with the fighting at the start.
Love the police them, and those, not buckle them, and remember.
One love, one Jamaica, a friendly rivalry we say.
A message brought to you by Students for Transformation.
You know what I want to say, Jamaica Magazine? Listen out for no go there. Nomads and Eve for Life. Seeing protecting our young girls, especially our young girls. No go there. Protect our children. Give thanks.
I'm in Zalikati Sea. They know.
What's the most significant heritage site in Jamaica? Do you know?
I am Captain. Affirmative.
Sick.
Anne.
Yeah! For us, my domain, the center of wealth for the world. Order! Order! As resident magistrate of the Mandeville Courthouse, I am guardian of this 197-year-old structure built with limestones by slaves.
I protest with all due respect. I have stood in defense of workers' rights in Jamaica. That is what Marabay Courthouse represents.
Marcus Garvey family, ancestors no leave me. Naya Bingi, Bobo Shanti. Ay, 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 ay. Oh, oh, oh.
We stood as protectors of this jewel of the isle, and the National Hero Circle celebrates our value. Their name liveth forevermore.
Hey, hey, listen. The blood of African kings run in my vein. Here in that Jamaica rebellion.
These are they who have founded the treasures right at home. Treasures that have withstood the ravages of time.
Pencil, paint, computer, history, and imagination. These were some of the tools that 36 blooming artists needed to answer the challenge for the first Jamaica Information Service Heritage Poster Competition under the theme, We Are Free. After 7 weeks, five entrants emerged from this kaleidoscope of color. Masika Adams, Giovanni Robinson, Sarah J. Little, Ryan Scott, and Duvet McKenzie. The top five were treated to a tour of the heart of art in Jamaica, the National Gallery.
A lot of his work is talking about issues surrounding slavery. But he's also talking about a variety of things in terms of contemporary life in Jamaica. What do you think this work is called, firstly? Surrounded by butterflies, a doll. The name of the work is Mariposa Negra, which means black butterfly. Think about black butterflies and think about how black people see themselves. It's really about our beauty as black people.
And one thing art has always been able to represent is the beauty of a people. After the completion of the tour, Mr. Lawrence spoke with the emerging artists about the uniqueness and beauty represented in their work.
Masika, now I noticed the chains in your work are two of the strongest elements. Why did you use chains in the work?
The chains which is not broken represent bondage.
Yes.
And the chain that are broken represent freedom.
And of course the work is about
freedom.
So it's a very good use of symbols in the work.
I use the sunlight to represent finding the light at the end of a tunnel.
Mm-hmm.
And I use the hummingbird to symbolize Jamaica, while the dove would symbolize peace and finding newfound land.
When I use the bird to do is, I represent it as Jamaicans flying away from all the stress and the burden, which would be the forest,
mm-hmm.
which is represented by the trees,
mm-hmm.
and then the bird would be flying away to the newfound land.
So Ryan, of all the posters that I've seen, yours has the most text on it. So why did you use this much text?
The case of a person with a vague mind or who aren't able to think as in depth, to simply look at the imagery and mm-hmm. understand what the poster is trying to depict.
You use an element specifically from the website for your vision of freedom, but you adjusted this one. Could you tell me why you did that?
All right, because the scene is in a ship.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted it to show that they're being held captive.
Yeah.
So the chains are there to show that because they were restrained. And then the cloth around her waist is to show that some people didn't make it across. Because
mm-hmm.
as you can see in the background, there are small shapes to show that they're close together, that they're compact in there.
5 extraordinary artists, and the first finalists for the Jamaica Information Service Heritage Poster Competition, all vying for the number one spot, all very deserving.
Did you know climate change is decreasing the quality and quantity of water?
Climate change is expected to affect all aspects of food security, especially in the tropical region of which we are a part.
Climate change related hazards such as prolonged droughts, more severe storms, and the overall irregularity of rainfall. These climatic stressors have resulted a reduction of water in our rivers and watersheds.
Youth, we are depending on you to spread the message of climate change and its impacts. Be a climate change agent in your home, school, or community. With climate change, we must change.
Chikungunya is a viral infection transmitted when an Aedes aegypti mosquito bites an infected person and then bites someone else. Symptoms include high fever, headache, joint pain, muscle pain, and rash. If you suspect that you've been infected, take paracetamol such as Panadol, Cetamol, and Tylenol. Infants, children under 5 years old, pregnant women, the elderly, persons with sickle cell, and chronic illnesses such as diabetes and cardiovascular disease are at risk for more severe symptoms and must see a doctor for proper evaluation and monitoring. Fortunately, most cases of CHIKV are mild, but if your symptoms worsen, you need to see a doctor. For more info, call 1-888-1-LOVE from 8:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. That number again, 1-888-663-5683.
And that's it for this Friday's edition of Jamaica Magazine. Do remember to view our features at jis.gov.jm. Follow us on Twitter at JIS News and send your feedback to jamaicamagazine@jis.gov.jm. I'm Adrian Atkinson, and this has been Jamaica Magazine. Another program comes your way tomorrow. Until then, do take care, and thank you for watching.
This has been a production of the Jamaica Information Service, the voice of Jamaica.